Hi guys, so today I did this makeup tutorial, which is really smoky and a bit sultry, but it's actually the daytime, so I decided not to go with false lashes since it was already so smoky and a bit dramatic. And I did a really nice purple all over the lid, some winged out liner, mascara, actually did a purple plummy shade on the cheeks, and then a very nice sparkly pink lip. So if you guys are interested in seeing how I achieve this makeup look, this look here. If you don't have the products that I used in this video, that's absolutely fine. Just use whatever you have available. If you don't really like purple and you don't feel it looks good on you, you can switch these colors out for whatever colors you want, and you can just follow the steps if you would like, so you don't have to use the exact same products that I used in this tutorial in order to achieve this look. Just use whatever you have. So just stay tuned for the makeup tutorial. Bye guys. Hi guys, so this is going to be a makeup tutorial. I want to do something purple. I don't know why I'm feeling like doing some purple on the eyes, so that's what I'm going to do. As always, you want to start off by priming your eyelids using any type of base or primer. I'm going to be using Urban Decay's Primer Potion, and this is just the original in the purple packaging. And I'm applying that from my lid up to my eyebrow and on my lower lash line as well. Next, I'm going to be putting down a purple base, and this is Ransom from Urban Decay. It's one of their liners, but I'm just going to use that as a base, and I'm just applying that very close to my lash line, just smudging it messily. And then I'm just going to take my finger and soften and blend this out and blend it up as well. For this look, I'm going to be using my Color 3 Quad, and this is from MAC's Spring Color Forecast collection that came out earlier in the spring. And it just has these four gorgeous purple shades, but you can use whatever it is that you have available. You don't have to use this palette if you don't have it. Just use whatever you have. And I'm going to be starting with this color here. And I believe that this is Jungle Moon. And it's just a very, very dark plum. And it's matte. And I'm just going to apply this all over my lid, right on top of the Ransom that I applied as a base. And I'm just applying this in a patting motion rather than sweeping it across. Next, I'm going to take a stiff tapered crease brush, and I'm going to go in with this shadow here, which is right next to the Jungle Moon, which I used on my lid. And this is called Black Tulip, and this is a frost finish. And I'm going to apply this in my crease to start to blend out the Jungle Moon that I used all over my lid. And I'm not really blending this upward, I'm just trying to soften that line. I believe that I have that blended enough for now. I'm going to just take the color that I used on my lid, which is Jungle Moon, and I'm going to apply that to my lower lash line. And this color is called Bruise Plum, and it's a Veluxe Pearl finish. And it's just a very soft, almost lavender. I'm going to apply this in my inner corner just to highlight my tear duct a bit. And then I'm just going to blend this here where these two colors meet. As a brow highlight, I'm actually going to be using Nanogold by MAC, and this is it right here. The camera isn't really picking up its true color. It's like a beige with a really gorgeous pink iridescence to it. So I think this would look good just softly underneath the brow with the purple. It's not going to really give a dramatic highlight, but it's just going to give a nice bit of pink iridescence under the brow when the light hits it. So to bring everything together so that it's very seamless, I'm going to take the last shade in the quad, and this is called Mink Pink, and it's just a very pale, soft pink. And I'm going to take my blending brush and just blend this into the crease just so that everything blends together really seamlessly. I'm going to apply some black pencil into my waterline. Now I'm going to line my upper lash line using this felt tip liner, and it's from Black Radiance, and it's a fine line liquid eyeliner pen, and here's what it looks like. On my cheeks, I applied a little blush already, and this is the Vintage Grape Blush Ombre, and this also came out with the Spring Color Forecast collection. And I just used a stippling brush and applied a bit to the apples of my cheeks, and then I just softly blended it out because this is very pigmented, so you don't want to apply too much. And you don't want it to be too overdone because it could look like you got punched in your face. So if you feel that you applied a bit too much, what you can do is you can take your face powder and your face powder brush and just get a bit of your face powder, not much, just a tiny bit, and then you can just buff that in on top of the blush, and that's going to soften it a bit. So you can see the difference between these two sides. Now that looks better. So for the lips, I want to do a really nice pink lip with this, a very soft pink lip. So I'm going to take my 32 color lip palette from BH Cosmetics, and I know that I use this palette a lot in my tutorials, but I really love this palette. It's so versatile and has such a wide variety of shades that you can find something that's perfect for every single look. I'm going to take this color here, and it's a very soft pink. This one right here. It's a very neutral, like a soft mauvey pink. So now I'm going to add a bit of gloss on top of this lip, and I'm going to be applying Shift to Pink Lipgelee on top, and here it is. So I hope you guys enjoyed this makeup tutorial with self. Thank you very much for watching, and as always, stay fabulous and don't let anyone tell you otherwise. Bye guys!